Everyone, this is Garima Soni, student of Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science, and for this presentation my topic is sleep. So here are some key topics that we are going to see in this presentation. First of all, what is sleep, its physiology, timing, functions of sleep, disorders, and some of the ways to sleep better. So what is sleep? Sleep is a naturally recurring state of mind and body characterized by altered consciousness, relatively inhibited sensory activity, inhibition of nearly all the voluntary muscles, and reduced interaction with surroundings. During sleep, most of the body's systems are in anabolic state, help to restore our immune system, nervous system, skeletal and muscular systems. These are vital processes that maintain mood, memory, cognitive performance, and plays a large role in the function of the endocrine and the immune system. Basically, sleep is a condition of mind and body which typically recurs for several hours every night, in which the nervous system is inactive, the eyes are closed, the postural muscles are relaxed, and consciousness practically suspended. So here the next one is physiology of sleep. The most pronounced physiological changes in sleep occur in the brain. Sleep increases the sensory threshold. In other words, sleeping person perceive fewer stimuli. However, they can generally still respond to loud noises and other salient sensory events. Sleep influences all the body's major physiological systems, including thermoregulatory, musculoskeletal, endocrine, respiratory, cardiovascular, gastrointestinal, and immune systems. Sleep also impacts individuals' weight, mental health, and overall quality of life. Non-REM and awakening. All these three comes under physiology of sleep. Usually, sleep is divided into two broad types, that is REM and non-REM. REM means rapid eye movement and non-REM means non-rapid eye movement. Non-REM sleep occurs first and after a transitional period is called slow wave sleep or deep sleep. During this phase, body temperature and heart rate fall and the brain use less energy. The REM phase is also known as paradoxical sleep and sometimes desynchronized sleep because of physiological similarities to waking states, including rapid low voltage, desynchronized brain waves. Awakening can mean the end of sleep or simply a moment to survey the environment and readjust body position before falling back asleep. So there are some timings of sleep, and the first one is circadian clock. Sleep timing depends greatly on hormonal signals from the circadian clock or process C. A complex neurochemical system which uses signals from an organism's environment to recreate an internal day-night rhythm. The circadian rhythm influences the ideal timing of a restorative sleep episode. Sleepiness increases during the night. Social timing. Humans are also influenced by aspects of social time. The hours when other people are awake, the hours when work is required, and the time on the clock, etc. Time zone standard time used to unify the timing for people in the same area correspond only approximately to the natural rising and setting of the sun. And the third one is nap. A nap is a short period of sleep, typically taken during daytime hours, as an adjunct to the usual nocturnal sleep period. Naps are most often taken as a response to drowsiness during waking hours. Though sleeping is a resting process, it contains some of the disorders. Disorders like insomnia. It is a general term for difficulty in falling asleep and staying asleep. Insomnia is the most common sleep problem with many adults. Insomnia can have many different causes, including psychological, stress, a poor sleep environment, an inconsistent sleep schedule, or excessive mental or physical stimulation in the hours before bedtime. And the second one is obstructive sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea is a condition in which major pauses in breathing occurs during sleep, disrupting the normal progression of sleep and often causing other more severe health problems. Apneas occur when the muscles around the patient's airway relax during sleep, causing the airway to collapse and block the intake of oxygen. Third one is narcolepsy. It is a long-term neurological disorder that involves a decreased ability to regulate sleep-wake cycles. Symptoms include periods of excessive daytime sleepiness that usually last from seconds to minutes and may occur at any time. So there are three main functions of sleep, that is restoration, memory processing, and dreaming. where restoration means when the human organism physically restores itself during sleep, healing itself and removing waste which builds up during periods of activity. This restoration takes place mostly during slow wave sleep, during which body temperature, heart rate and brain oxygen consumption decreases. And the next one is memory processing. Sleep enhances memory, with procedural memory benefiting from late REM-rich sleep and explicit memory benefiting from early slow-wave-rich sleep. And the third one is dreaming. During sleep, especially REM sleep, people tend to have dreams, elusive first-person experience, which, despite their frequently bizarre qualities, seem realistic while in progress. Dreams can seamlessly incorporate elements within a person's mind that would not normally go together. They can include apparent sensations of all types, especially vision and movement. So last but not the least, there are some ways to sleep better. First of all, first develop a sleep routine. It might seem tempting, but sleeping until noon on Saturday will only disrupt your biological clock and cause more sleeping problems. Going to bed at the same time every night, even on weekends, holidays and other days off, helps to establish your internal sleep-wake clock and reduces the amount of tossing and turning required to fall asleep. Change your diet. Cut out the food and drinks that contain caffeine, such as coffee, tea, soft drinks and chocolate, by mid-afternoon. Make dinner your lightest meal and finish it hours before bedtime. Skip spicy or heavy foods, which can keep you awake with heatburn or indigestion. Third one is don't smoke. A study found that smokers are 4 times more likely to not feel well as well as rested after a full night's sleep than non-smokers. Fourth one is black it out. Light tells your brain that it's time to wake up, so make your room as dark as possible for sleep. Sleeping is a beautiful thing. If you feel you are not getting enough sleep or not enjoying quality sleep, these simple adjustments can help contribute to a more restful night.